What makes wilderness astronomy unique as a course is that you feel awe-inspired for so much of it, essentially. When you're out backpacking around, the landscapes are awe-inspiring, and when you're thinking about what's up in the night sky, that's also inspiring. And that's a feeling that I get a lot when I do both those things. It is a one-of-a-kind experience for an undergrad. I think like everything else they are likely to experience as a student is going to be mostly PowerPoint-based or sitting in a classroom and listening to somebody talk, versus going on this trip, the concepts that we talk about, they will actually be able to experience in various ways, and that is not something you get to do as a student otherwise. We talk about how the atmosphere works, and you get to feel the temperature change as you climb up a mountain.
When students are standing out there looking at the real night sky for the very first time, seeing, you know, what the Milky Way really means, what all the stars out there really look like, there's this moment where we realize that every human before us and every human after us will have also had that same moment of staring up at the night sky.
When we look up in the sky, each of those stars probably has a planet of its own, or multiple planets, and all those planets work the same way that our planet does. So when we learn about how our planet works, we're learning about how all planets work. My favorite object to look at in the night sky is Orion's sword, because I know that in the middle of that sword is a nebula where new stars and planets are forming, and when you see that through a telescope, it looks phenomenal.
As scientists, we get to discover so many cool things about the way that our world works or the way that our universe works. And we want you to discover that you can think the way that scientists think, and that you can also discover just how beautiful the world is the way that we get to discover every day.